Now to the shooting death of a student from West Bend on the Purdue University campus.
Andrew Bolt was 21 years old. He was teaching a class in a basement classroom when he was killed. Police arrested another student, Cody Cousins. Cousins will be in court tomorrow afternoon. So far, police do not know why this shooting happened. Purdue University's president, Mitch Daniels, talked about the shooting today.
Well, it's stunning. You know, let's face it, we live in a violent society, and these tragedies happen. We're probably too numb to them sometimes, but there's something about it happening in a place of learning on a college campus. Obviously, when it happens to a young person, a brilliant young person, these things, I think, make it hit us harder.
And for those who knew the victim, it was perhaps even more shocking.
Andrew Bolt was smart and well-liked. Friends gathered at Marquette High School this afternoon to remember the good time.
Today's TMJ4's Michelle Fiore spoke with his classmates, who are shaking their heads, Michelle, in disbelief.
Well, Steve and Carol, friends called Andrew Tito, or Drew Bolt. He was a likable guy at Marquette High, and he will be sorely missed.
Andrew Bolt, seen here at his junior prom, had a fun spirit.
The one thing that I always maintain is just that he was just such a funny kid. You know, he was always a fun person to be around.
Will Carver said lunchtime and class retreats at Marquette High School brought the two together. The 2010 graduate is also described as someone who took initiative and exhibited leadership qualities in the Marquette Robotics Club and in Eagle Scouts.
Probably the most important thing to me is, you know, how smart he was and how polite he was.
Polite and kind, taken away far too soon.
You know, when I heard who it was last night on the way home from work, I was just shocked.
The Bolt family donated money to the school as a tribute to their three sons. This sign in the parking lot now serves as a reminder to grief-stricken students as they pray for the family.
I mean, everybody that is at Marquette High, it's such a faith-filled community. Life is all about the people you spend it with. And I feel like anybody that spent time with Andrew Bolt in their life definitely was given a gift.
And the Bolts Church is planning a prayer service and rosary tonight. It's at St. Francis Cabrini in West Bend at 7 o'clock. Stephen Carroll.
So sad. Thank you, Michelle.
It was a somber morning at Marquette University High School. Students returned to class for the first time since learning about the death of Andrew Bolt. The routine looked the same on the outside. Parents dropping off their kids, students grabbing their books and saying goodbye. Inside the halls today, nothing like they've ever experienced before. Noah Alcorta and his classmate Alejandro Esquivel never met Andrew, but that did not matter.
I told my parents about it, and I was just like, it's just unbelievable that happened, or that someone who was so young or who just graduated a couple years ago could have died like that.
Here at Marquette, it's kind of a brotherhood, so he's definitely a brother from Marquette, so it kind of affects us in a different way.
Andrew Bolt's older brother also attended Marquette High School. His younger brother is a senior there now.
And this sign outside the Pettit National Ice Center along I-94 has the Purdue logo and says prayers. There is a vigil tonight for those who want to remember Andrew Bolt. We'll have much more in the story coming up on Live at 10.